Philadelphia Eagles. I'll have scores around the league for you at the half. But it's time for a little football. So we'll hand it over to our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach. It's the NFL and the sports as you take a look there. Technics ablaze. They're set to go as their Eagles will match up with the Carolina Panthers. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at this Eagles team as they interplay here. The losers their last time out, so they'll look to make amends here.
And one of the best ways you can do that is to be at home, and they are. They're going to try and ride that home crowd and that wave of emotion to a victory in this one.
On the other side of the field for the visiting Panthers, they too were losers last week, so they're also hoping to get back in the win. Getting toward the halfway point of the NFL season, week 7 is underway on EA Sports. On the return, it's Kenyon Barber. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. So here are the Panthers now for their opening drive. And they'll be led out by the NFL's most valuable player from 2015. It's Cam Newton.
I love just about everything about him. Love his game, love his makeup, love his moxie. One of my favorite words. This guy's a competitor. Gritty, tough, you name it, he's got it. But he did throw an interception in last week's game. That contributed to a loss. And despite the fact he threw 3 touchdown passes, he's going to be out there redoubling his efforts and trying to play better.
And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. The numbers for McCaffrey last week. 16 carries, 57 yards, and a touchdown as well.
I'm so glad you asked for a couple of offensive linemen to talk to before the game, because they told us that in last week's contest, everything was clicking. Didn't matter whether they were doing gap scheme, zone scheme, power, whatever it was working. And they expect more of the same in this game, although they're prepared for some adjustments by the defense they expect to see.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. And here now the offense for Carolina.
Right now, you know I love running backs. And C.J. Anderson coming in a big way in 2017. His first 1,000-yard season on the ground. A little bit over 5 yards in 1,007. But over 1,200 yards from scrimmage. So you know you can catch it out of the backfield and go. And second runner, a powerful runner, and that can be physical when necessary.
Newton to Olsen there for a Carolina first down.
That throw's not going to get him a whole lot, but that really didn't matter. They got what they needed on that throw. Picked up the first down, and I'm going cliche here. Game of inches, partner.
Absolutely. Well, and you talked to me a lot about opening drives, how key those are to set the tone. You kept the drive alive. Third down conversion here is big. Check on his status when we get back. Now a carry. It's C.J. Anderson. He'll get about 3 as he's brought down right around the 42. Starters, here they are for Philadelphia. They interplay 1 from the bottom. They were 31 in the league, Charles, against the run.
And that's been an Achilles heel for them all season long, being able to play against the run, being able to slow teams down. But it's not just that. When you give up big chunks of yardage in the running game, it also opens up the passing options for the team you're playing as well. So typically, when you don't play the run well, you're getting hit in all phases.
Throwing on third down, Newton. Just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. Give him 7 on the play, and that'll bring up 4th down. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, but they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
So on fourth down, kicking it away here, Michael Pilardi. Back deep is Darren Sproles. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. So now here comes the Eagles offense as they get ready to take over. They'll be led out by their 6'5 quarterback out of North Dakota State. It's Carson Wentz.
I loved his quote during the week. If I were a defensive back, I would have wanted to play against me last week as well. He's trying to eliminate those turnovers, those interceptions, and get back on the positive side of the ledger throwing touchdown passes.
Yeah, had four of those picks, led to the loss.
Hey, go, go.
Now it's the Boise State alum, Jay Ajayi. And he'll get only a couple up to the 22. Quickly now, a look at the Eagles' offensive starters.
An electric force out of the backfield is Jay Ajayi, who made the most out of his midseason exit from Miami and acquisition by the Philadelphia Eagles. The leading rusher in the playoffs for the Eagles helped power them to a Super Bowl with the ability to see holes where people don't think they exist and turn them into long runs.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Defensively, here are the starters for Carolina. They've been excellent against the pass, the number six unit in the NFL.
Yeah, defending the pass hasn't been an issue for them. It's been stopping the run. And if they don't stop the run, they can't get back to their strength, which is guarding against the air attack.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a third and eight. Working from the gun, Wentz, and he connects with Hurts. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. An Eagle first down there, Wentz to Hurts, and the names that end in TZ. On first and 10, here's Wentz. And it's incomplete. He was trying to get it to Zach Hurts that time, and that'll bring up second down. That's already the third time they've looked his way on this opening drive. He's caught one of the three.
That doesn't mean they won't continue to go in that direction. It feels like they think they've got something good going there, and they think those numbers are going to increase.
Play action. Now Wentz. He finds his target, Terrence Williams. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
Here's Ajayi. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Given 12 yards on that one, it earns him a flat shot of downs.
And there we see an early burst that makes him one of the leading rushers in the league.
Well, I want you to know, I listened to you yesterday when we were watching film. You said, write down the word vision for him. It was on display there, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because he allows the blocks to set up in front of him. And if that continues, it'll be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
So after the run by Jay Ajayi, here's first and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. Pressure here, and down he goes. Sacked back at about the 43-yard line. Julius Peppers in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year.
This offensive line has struggled. In fact, when we sat down with the coach, he said it's been in tatters lately. They allowed six sacks in their last game, just gave up another one right there.
In tatters, so it sounds a little bit like this right now?
Exactly. It's like that paper being ripped. And right now, they've got to find a way to get it back together.
That
after the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. They run with a jogger. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. It'll be a gain of 15 on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down.
It seemed like the situation was second and a mile to go for a first down, which screams what? Throw the football. You got to pass in order to try to pick up that kind of yardage. But in this case, they ran a tendency breaker because the tendency is for defenses to be out there and be set up for a pass. So you break tendency and actually run the football. That changes everything because if you're able to find a crease, you often have bigger guys working on smaller guys down.
That's too strong. They get there and take him down. Julius Peppers in there to get him. And that's sack number 6 for him on the year.
Hindsight is 20-20, partner. Maybe she kicked it on the ground again.
Well, it almost looked like the O-line was run-blocking again. I mean, they opened up a big hole last time. This time they opened up a hole, and the quarterback got sacked. So on fourth down, here's the veteran left-footed punter, Donnie Jones, to kick it away. Oh, what a play on special teams here. This is going to be down inside the 5, all the way down at the 2-yard line. Offense, they get set to come back onto the field. They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again, so it's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up 5 or 6 first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory.
Now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first
time
this afternoon.
Offense.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Following the penalty, Anderson. And he will forge his way forward only up to the 2-yard line. The tackle was made by Michael Bennett.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
From the end zone, Newton. And his throw here is incomplete. He was looking for the connection with Devin Funchess. That takes us from second to third down.
And the seam pass is knocked down by those guys that are called the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers. You know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
Step! 180!
Third down now, C.J. Anderson. Fights through the middle crease. They were looking for a little spark and some breathing room. They got it right there, a gain of 14 and a first down.
And that's the big fella's M.O. right there. Running through tackles, keeping the sticks moving forward. This defense, if you don't bring 11 guys to the ball to try and get him on the ground, he's going to keep making runs like that. I feel the press box shaking every time he touches the rock.
So that last play gives him a little more space now. Here's first and 10 at the 16-yard line. They run again on first down, Anderson. And he runs across the 20 to the 24-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and 2. Now you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
Nowhere to go that time. Might have gotten a yard up to the 25.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, He looked like one of those guys.
Newton looking to throw on third and one. And he finds a man. It's Harrison. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains. Gotta say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they picked up the first down.
Now the former Oregon man, it's a Simeon Barber, and he'll be tackled right on the chalk at a 45. 12 yards there as they move the chains. The first drive this unit had, they punted. This drive, much more balanced, just looking crisper, aren't they, moving the ball.
Maybe the first drive is a little bit of a wake-up call. Probably a little bit angry that they had to punt the ball away the first time they had it. Got motivated, got to the sideline, said, okay, let's not let that happen here as we take over again.
So after two first downs, they get another here. First and 10 at the 45. They go play action here on first down.
Another one right here. He's been remarkable lately. I think that goes all the way back to not just his offseason, but the film study he's been doing during the week, because I think he's found matchups that he likes, and he's capitalizing.
Yeah, a few times he's even defeated double teams. He doesn't care at this point. Yeah, I imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Handoff comes to Anderson. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. It's a gain of 7 on the ground, but they'll be faced with third and long. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. They're talking about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. So we've reached the end of a fairly even first quarter of play. Nothing our score. EA Sports NFL Sunday returns following this.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
With my good friend Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin with you. It's the Panthers in possession of the football as we begin quarter number 2. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. First down. Here's the run with Anderson. It's coming as they're going to stop him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Michael Bennett's versatility, being able to play any position along the defensive front, allows him to make those types of plays. He finds good matchups and gets into the offensive backfield.
And there it works for a tackle for loss. 1 yard officially on the pickup, and it'll leave him with a third and 11.
Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
Black 80.
To throw on third down. Newton. And Olsen over the middle. And he went down at the 28.
So much about offense is what we call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. And Gano's kick is right through. And the Panthers stake claim to a 3-0 lead. Well, they started that drive all the way back at the 1, able to march down, get 3.
It was daunting to begin with, wasn't it? But I thought overall, a very poised and efficient drive to get 3 points.
After knocking through the field goal, here's Gano back out there now for the kickoff. This is taken near the 13.
gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And they had a long drive going last time, but it stalled out. But still, maybe something positive to carry forward from that last drive.
Well, a few different things that you carry forward. Number one, as you noted, they were moving it pretty well, so that gives them a lot of confidence. The second part is keeping defense off the field gives them a chance to rust up a little bit. And last but not least, you've taken a good look at what you've done on offense, noted where the weaknesses are, and you know when you want to come back to it.
Like when you're organized with your points. Well done.
A, B, and C.
Now it's the all-purpose back. This is Darren Sproles. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Now wins on third down. Screen pass to Sproles. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. They lost two, and it brings up four. Well, you can see what they wanted to do. They wanted to set up the screen there, but it got blown up.
It's hard to run that play if you're not getting a lot of pressure at the quarterback because the space doesn't open up. They were able to read that one and slow it down and stop it before they could get a first down.
And onto the field, here come the Panthers. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, try to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
On second down, here's Newton. This hit is incomplete. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
They really turned it loose, didn't they? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to completion, but made it very difficult.
Now it's Newton. Here's the man of Smith.
And the key number on that play, three. Third play of the drive. Third down, spectacular catch, turns into a first down.
First down saves them from a three and out. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Newton on first down. It's caught on the right side of Smith. Torrey Smith, watch him go. Touchdown. Torrey Smith, his second touchdown on the season. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Gano on for the extra point. Gano the extra point, and the lead grows to 10-0. A four-play drive spanning 80 yards, and Carolina scores to cap it off. Gano out to kick this one away. This is taken at his four. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. They've had it twice. They punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice. So They're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
Here's a handoff to Sproles to start the drive. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. In on the tackle there, Luke Kuechly.
When we talk about Luke Kuechly, you can't talk about his overall game without talking about his intelligence and how he controls the whole defense. He quarterbacks that defense, and at times will actually make checks. Just like a quarterback would on offense to get him into the right defense. They definitely were on that play. How about that finish? Holding that to a minimal gain.
Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a third and eight.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. Here's Donnie Jones now, as he's on to punt for Philadelphia. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And a great job on special teams to down it, as this will be marked down inside the 5-yard line. Now we get a look at Torrey Smith as he comes back out onto the field. He's doing what he's capable of, having a solid game. Not the most amazing game. He's not over 100 yards, but a good game so far.
And you just know that mentally, he feels like he's one catch away from turning it into a great game and starting on that road. And the defenders are well aware of that, too. We've got to figure out a way to not let that escalate. Keep him right in the zone here and call it a day, because otherwise, he can really decimate him.
Better believe they are well aware of his playmaking ability. And the first play of the drive there is incomplete.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. 10th carry now for Anderson. And a short gain here as he gets it up only to about the 6. He only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a 3rd and 8 forthcoming.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure down at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
On third down, Newton. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender is making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. Here's Michael Pilardi now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Now a fair catch taken, maybe a yard or two shy of midfield. They call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And the Eagles will have great starting field position here as they take over. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. So far, they've had 3 drives, 3 punts. Not good.
Not good indeed, because you've got to have something to show for being out on the field. Now, sometimes, if you have a game where neither side has scored, 3 punts isn't a bad thing. But when you're trying to set the pace, get up on top in a game, you've got to show better offense and find a way to put some points on the board.
To throw his wins. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. No gain there on the completion, 2nd and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. And the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's 2nd and 10. Now Wentz. And this is Ertz with it, right side. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face 3rd down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on 2nd down. That was a positive play, because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives him a much better opportunity to convert on 3rd down.
Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a 4th down.
score will stay right where it is.
It looked good when it left his foot, but he kind of sliced it a little bit, and he winds up missing it wide right.
Cam Newton getting ready to go again on offense. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number two here in the second quarter. Nigel Bradham brings him down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't throw up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in a good position on second down.
Now Newton. That's caught inside the 20. And they're going to be settled down around the 15-yard line. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. We often, with Cam Newton, talk a lot about his legs. Don't forget about that arm.
He can throw it on a rope. He can loft it. He's got the touch that's been developed throughout his career. But the big part about just watching him throw it, it seems almost effortless.
Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. They give it to Anderson. And he's going to find his way forward here for a nice game. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. Two minutes to play here in the first half. We'll come back to Philadelphia after this. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Here's Newton now on second down. Dancing to his left. And he will score. Touchdown, Panthers. Cam Newton, his 10th touchdown of the season, second of the game. And the Panthers add on to their lead. Well, the defensive coverage was good, so good he just decided to make a play of his own, and it worked out.
Yeah, you often wonder if they think to themselves, was the coverage too good to allow him to run the football? But I think you'd rather take your chances with him doing exactly that. And he beat him on that play all the way to the end zone.
Gano now to add the extra point. Extra point try good by Gano. And that makes our score 17-0. So that drive, 4 plays. And Cam able to take it himself in for the score. Gano out to kick this one away. This one taken from the 7. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Alshon Jeffrey working his way back out there now to help lead this offense. You better believe that he's well aware he has 0 catches right now, and they're losing, so he's probably a little hungry.
And you know the guys on defense are aware as well, and they're really excited that he has no catches, but they're also worried, because a lot of times, that's like the ticking time bomb. The longer you hold him down, when he finally explodes,
look out. No catches, though, so far in this game. Throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete. And that one goes incomplete. They tried something out of the bag of tricks, but it's incomplete in their second down. Back to the air on second down. Wins. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
If you're running out route, it's likely you're going to end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there? You got it. The benefits of practice. Touchdown, foot dragging, picking it up and making sure it was a catch.
And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. 7 yards on the quick slant and a first down. On first down, Wentz. They showed up a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring him down. 7 yards, the pickup on the vision catch. Rent's going to throw. It's complete to Williams. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. It's a 7 yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. Wentz now to throw. And slides to avoid the hit. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half.
There's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. Now Wentz. He's got his man. It's Williams. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. That one good for seven as his long drive continues and the chains move again.
Now that's absolutely frustrating for a defender. Had a chance to get him on the ground before he got to the sideline. But what great vision and understanding where he is on the field as he headed for the ground and picked up the first down.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Wentz now on first down. Into heavy traffic and it's intercepted. It's Shaq Thompson here with a pick. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. It's almost like you can see the look of frustration on his face. Four interceptions last week. We talked about it all week. What did he do wrong? And another one here in the first half.
And you can understand the frustration. You actually feel his pain a little bit. But the worst thing he can do is what you're seeing right now, showing the other team that he's frustrated. All they're going to do is double their efforts to make him even more frustrated. He's got to gather himself, compose himself, and keep fighting.
Well, he talked a lot about erasing that loss last week, getting back in the win column. We'll see how he responds. From the 34 now, here's first and 10.
Set,
here's Anderson as they begin this series on the ground. And they run into the ground just shy of midfield. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. Cam leads the Panthers up following the sack. Carolina facing third and long. Here's Anderson. So we come upon halftime. Intermission here with the visiting Panthers taking the lead to the locker room. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. A lot to get to here as some of the division races starting to take shape. As we look around the NFL here in week number 7. We'll get things started in the heartland, Kansas City, as they're at home to take on Cincinnati. And it's the Bengals who are out in front as those two head towards the break. Brandon LaFell, a touchdown reception. From there, we take the long trek eastward to Tampa, check on the Bucs at home at Raymond James Stadium. And for the moment, they trail the visiting Browns in that one. The Browns trying to gut this one out, as it would be a good victory for them if they could get it. Finally, we finish at MetLife Stadium to see what's going on with the Jets. And it's the visiting Minnesota Vikings who are out in front. Stephon Diggs, a touchdown reception. In our game, it was Cam Newton who led the way in that first half. His guys lead on the road at the defending champs as we send you back up to Philly for the second half with Brandon Godden.
Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Panthers out in front, and they will get the football first. Second half action underway. Carson Wentz and the Eagles make their way out to the field, and he's had some time to chew on that interception he threw on his last drive back in the first half.
Well, normally we say, why get him right back out on the field and play again, right? But as you mentioned, had the halftime, had to stew about it a little bit. Maybe he'll have a chance to relax a little and kind of laugh and chuckle and let it go.
He'll hope to respond positively here to start the third quarter. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
Here we go.
This is a Johnny. And he'll get this out to about the 38-yard line. Tackle made by Thomas Davis.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he'll be taken down about before he gets into enemy territory. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
Would you say this offense is locked in right now?
They're having no trouble on this drive. What is it, three plays, three first downs?
Yeah, you talk about on the march. They keep this up, they'll get to that end zone real fast.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10.
Go, go. 180!
Now it's a giant. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Luke Kuechly combines speed, intelligence, toughness, puts it all together. It makes plays like one we just saw there. He may not be a big-time blitzer, but boy, he knows how to pursue straight ahead and make plays in the run game.
Toes inbounds. The reception good for seven. It's third down. They've really been able to contain Alshon Jeffrey. That catch a rare exception in this game.
And that's a feather in their cap because he's such a tone setter for his team on offense that they try and get him the ball early. And, of course, what comes after that is often. And for them to limit him and then not catch a ball until the second half, it's a big reason why his team is behind on the scoreboard.
Rolling now is Wentz. No escape, and he goes down. Kaywan Short in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year.
Looks like another empty possession here, partner. I don't think with three scores down in the third quarter, they can truly afford any more the rest of the way.
No, especially the way their offense is sputtering. I think you're exactly right. They got to find some answers quickly.
Here's Donnie Jones now. He's been one of their few bright spots so far. A 39-yard punt, a return of five, and the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. The Panthers offense now, they head back on the field for their first possession of the second half. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown, it's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, you can take the spirit away from another team. Their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
It's still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they? One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. They run Anderson, and he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beat. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage.
The Panthers on third down. 5 out of 9 thus far. This will be third and five. From the gun, here's Newton. He's got his target. That's Moore. And he's going to get to the 31 and up for the first down. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't they?
Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time. Really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
Newton now 9 of 15 throwing the ball, 60%, and it's first and 10. Another toe here for the workhorse this afternoon. It's Anderson. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
To throw on second down is Newton. Just short of the 45 at the 44. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. He can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz game, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
And a scary incompletion, almost picked off. It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, as it turned out. Couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It's way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
Set. 180.
Back to the ground. Anderson. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. Call it a gain of 4, and it'll leave him with a third down and 6 to go.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Throwing on third down, Newton. And this is going to be incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution? execution of that defense right there. Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
And out now come the Eagles. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They can just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
And they give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
They'll come up second and six now from the 24.
Here we go, here we go. 20!
They run a draw here on second down. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage.
But these guys are going to chop into that deficit. They got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage would be found.
These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. Wins. And in double coverage, and it's intercepted. It's Shaq Thompson here with a pass. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. Just a little bit. Interceptions now in these last 2 weeks combined.
I know the easy thing is to go back to mechanics, footwork, things of that nature. I'm also wondering, is he getting fooled by what he's seeing on defense? Has the scouting report changed? Are they showing him things different than what he expected? For the second week in a row, he's throwing it to the guys in the wrong color shirts.
Yeah, he better figure, whatever the reason is, he better figure it out. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Ready!
Cam's going to run the option right. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. A solid job using his legs. 16 yards and a first down on the keeper.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point. Going to make that defense stand up and stop it. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
Carry number 20 coming up for Anderson. And he's going to find his way forward here for a modest game. And he gets them a little over half of what they needed. Now they're looking at a 3rd and 5.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
From the gun on third down, Newton. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Greg Olsen, his 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Panthers add on to their lead. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. Gano the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. 5 plays there on that drive. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown. Gano out to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Eagles offense back out onto the field. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is, just what you said, you're going over the changes. I thought they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Ross Cockrell. And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line. That is now seven interceptions between last week and this week. Three in this game, four a week ago.
And I saw the head coach write on his play sheet, make a little note. I hope he's writing self-scout. Bring in the guys that scout games for you with a different eye and watch him and see what's going on, and maybe they can pick up what the flaws are and hopefully they can correct them.
Getting set to go again here, Cam Newton marches back onto the field. He has been consistent, hasn't he? He played well in the first quarter, good second quarter, and now continuing that here in the third.
And that's the word that they're always seeking from the guy taking the snaps, is consistency. Taking care of the ball, making sure it gets to the right people, no errors, right? Not turning it over.
And the ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off by Ryan McLeod. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And they needed a break. They needed to make a play here in the third quarter. Defensively, they did that. Now they got to go quickly and get some points on the board.
And the best part is that they made their own break, taking the ball away. Now they just look at their offense and say, guys,
let's go.
Come on, capitalize on this one.
Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give him a chance.
Maybe play action.
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in it, and let him fling another one.
And he's dropped just shy of the 25 at the 24. Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down.
So much for him being bottled up throughout the day. Finally finds a way to break through and get a really nice gain. The defense has felt great about what they had going. Now they've got to turn their attention to getting it back in that direction. They're going to follow him up again, because I'd say after that run, confidence is pretty high for him.
Four down. Here we go. 20. Good
shot. They go play action here on first down. They're rolling that right. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be second down.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number four. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Only a gain of a yard there, but it indeed gets him a new set of downs.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield, because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
Here we go. 20.
On first and 10, here's Williams. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden the secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Wentz will try again on second down. And this is caught. I think he got that with one hand. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down.
One-handed. Love the effort. Not much production on that play, though, huh?
Not a whole lot of yardage. You get that grab, you probably want a first down.
And he'll be the one in the film session if he's saying, hey, run that one back, coach. Run that one back.
One more time.
Let's see that again. And they won't.
Eight more times.
They won't. Didn't get much out of it.
And that is incomplete.
Hang in there now. Hang in there now.
Sometimes it's just not your day. There's another failure right there on third down.
Now flags come in here. Look like one of the Eagles might have moved.
False start. Offense.
So that'll back them up five. They're already slim hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down. Since the second half started, 7 of 7. It's first and 10. Again, they'll throw with Wentz. Chuckling with a catch outside. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. 11 more on that one, and another first down. Hard to believe his first catch of the game defensively. They bottled him up. That's why they're well on their way to victory.
Put your best cover guy on it, and then change the coverages behind him throughout the game. Brackets, double, zone, man, you name it. Make sure he gets a lot of angles.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10, right at the 40.
There we go, back there.
Now, Wentz again. Catch made right side by Wilson. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Wins. Parks over the middle. And he'll go down at the 28. An Eagle first down, Wentz to Ertz.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw it, and was able to make the sure catch and put the down marker back to 1.
And that'll make it second down.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
Come on now. Come on now. Let's go.
Now flags come in here. Look like one of the Eagles might have moved.
False start. Offense.
And maybe they were coming with a blitz that time, and it caused a jump.
I think if we saw it, you know that they saw it. Might have been a little discussion down there. Bad guys coming. Pick them up. Pick them up. And someone jumped.
Here we go. Here we go. It's
on second down, here's Wentz. That's a short one here. Complete to the tight end. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football, So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
Interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target.
Hang in there now. Last catch
nearly got him a first, but it did not. And they'll try to convert on third and inches.
Go. Sweeney!
Working from the gun, wins, and he connects with Ertz, and he picks up the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 16. They'll get just a couple, but the sticks move again.
Really? Really? Did we just see that? That's a big catch. One-handed, I might add, to pick up the first
down. False start, offense.
For the defense, it's one thing to give up a reception. You just got to shake your head on a one-handed catch to pick up the first. False start backs him up five, first and 15.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. It'll be a loss of a yard, and they'll be facing a third and 12. Shotgun now for Wentz. And this is caught. Sets up a first and goal.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
It's been a struggle. Now Wentz going to lead the Eagles up to go for two. They're going to give it to Sproles. And they'll find his way in for two. And we're back to a two-score game. The lead's cut to 16. That's still an uphill battle from here, that's for sure. But that makes it a two-score game.
And now we see why teams practice so much on the two-point conversion, why you have more than one play ready. Because you may need multiples to throw out a ball game. Here's a great example right there.
Elliott now to kick this one away. Carolina getting set to take the field. Well, don't look now, but they've got a little bit of a battle on their hands again. Back to a two-score game. The interception that led to a touchdown. You'd have to think they're a little more careful here if they do indeed try to throw the football.
Yeah, and I was a little surprised by the last throw. You know, that type of throw with this type of a game, I would be very careful about it. Maybe the only throw you make is maybe a toss to your halfback or something like that. Otherwise, take care of the thing and finish this bad boy off.
An ideal beginning of the drive there as they'll get 20 and a first down. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up with a different era. We think about sportsmanship and all that. Other people think about fantasy points and getting their numbers. That's all they care about right now.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion. Have a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
Now a run with Anderson. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. We'll give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
Do my eyes deceive? deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Again, Anderson. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column. Have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and 7. Now Anderson. And he'll get inside the 40, but maybe the 38-yard line. And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here. They'll run it. Here's Anderson. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. Here's Michael Pilardi now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
Wentz now on first down. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well.
Personal
this
foul.
One's going to be a face mask.
Face mask. Defense.
Well, when you're leading in the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not automatic first down.
Discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense. First and 10. From the gun, it's Wentz. Wentz has it left side. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Now Wentz. Goes underneath for Sproles. A swift move and then tackled just on the other side of midfield. Call it a pickup of 7, and they'll be faced with a 3rd and inches. Now Wentz. Almost intercepted it. They're just forcing it into too many tough spots. That was almost a 4th pick of the game. And now 4th down.
Trying to decipher what's going on out there, because I don't know if he's just getting bad reads. I don't know if the defense is confusing him. I don't know if he just has, you know, bad info and intel before he snaps the ball. But he's made some pretty bad decisions with the football lately.
Yeah, several bad decisions on the interceptions he's thrown in. Frankly, that should have been another pick right there.
Tight end right.
it's a first down. Now a play fake here on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. We have not seen a whole lot of wide open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive, knowing each other's moves all game long. And they've been on the spot just about every time.
And they've held them in check on the scoreboard. Out to the right here to Wilson. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Now Wentz on third down. And this is going to be incomplete. James Bradbury, he was right there to break it up.
So it looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
Wentz now to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that's going to be just about all she wrote for this one. Carolina getting set to take the field. They got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage. Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. Football League, Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you prime the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So for Carolina, they're into the win column for the third time this year as they get the victory here. And they'll head back home next week to take on the Baltimore Ravens. Meanwhile, for Philadelphia, they dip to 2-5 now with the loss. And they'll be on the road next week as they get a date with the Jaguars in Jacksonville. I'm Brandon Gaudin. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.